Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content. And with that being said, let's begin. With Capcom's Resident Evil 8 title looming over the horizon, it would only appear now that both rumors and leaks are starting to pick up more so now than ever before, as courtesy of BloodyDisgusting.com, Resident Evil 8 is in fact rumored to be the quote darkest and most gruesome entry within the series so far. And this comes courtesy of AestheticGamer1 over on Twitter, who went along to tweet the following as I quote, "I don't know much on Silent Hill I haven't shared, but it's apparently revealed soon, so I'm looking forward to it. I still believe it from what I was shown, but I do have a healthy skeptic in me. Resident Evil 8, I'm excited for the reveal. It's by far the darkest and most gruesome Resident Evil yet." As of course, a Twitter user went along to ask, "I need more info." Aesthetic Gamer went along to respond, "Get ready for the most disturbing enemy designs in the Resident Evil series." Now, what's interesting to note about Resident Evil 8 that I think really is going to captivate the Resident Evil fan base is the fact that we're going to be getting, accordingly enough, based on many sources and many rumors of people that have experienced and played Resident Evil 8 in terms of its early stages, have indicated reports that the game itself is going to solely focus on making the game as dark, gruesome, bloody, and horrifying as humanly possible. Now, these elements actually include witches, possible werewolves, and enemies that are going to be far and beyond any other design we've seen within the Resident Evil franchise, which again is essentially refreshing, but at the same time is a little concerning when looking at the overall narrative in terms of direction for Ethan Winters' character and seeing what they're going to be doing with Chris Redfield and potentially many other characters, with the setting itself having to be very barren, having to be very cold and seemingly immersive when it comes down to its overall environment having to be explored. But Dust Golem actually went along to also have some comments in regards to Resident Evil 8, as an article went along to state, and I quote, "Speaking on Twitter, Dust Golem said that they were excited for an incoming reveal, nothing that Resident Evil 8 would be, by far, quote, the darkest and most gruesome Resident Evil yet. They also noted that along with a redesigned Chris Redfield, Resident Evil 8 features enemies that are, quote, more disturbing in the series, which is saying something about a brand that gives us liquors, regenerators, and Marguerite Baker." So this goes as far as to illustrate a narrative that we're going to be seeing enemies that are going to be, quote, more disturbing than anyone we've ever seen before, including liquors, regenerators, Marguerite Baker, and assumingly Crimson Heads, Hunters, and many other enemies, which I am personally excited for, and I think you should be too, because this is going to give us an opportunity as a fan base to actually see something different. Now, there is additional info, as the article went along to read, and I quote, "Most notable, however, is probably the suggestion that Resident Evil 8's story will be, quote, divisive and contains narrative beats that are, quote, actually horrible and effed up. I've avoided reprinting any further details here for spoiler reasons, but given the hype surrounding the uber grim titles such as The Last of Us Part 2, currently looking like one of the bleakest games ever made, it would be understandable why Capcom might want to take its horror franchise further over the line." Which is good, and although Capcom is making a lot of promises to us in keeping the game true to its title and giving us a story that is not only going to be dark and gruesomely horrifying, but also this is actually looking like Capcom is going to stick by their guns and try to make this game as pleasingly satisfying to the hardcore fans as possible, while also at the same time bringing in newer fans to keep the product alive. And through this concept, from what it appears to be, Capcom really wants to introduce not only a different element and environment to the game, but also by including a cult, witches, werewolves, zombies, everything basically boils down to finding out the main source of what is going on and what is happening. And this overall narrative could be reflective on a corporation or a pharmaceutical enterprise being behind this, as of course seen with Umbrella, which Umbrella could still be behind these newer versions of these zombies and witches and werewolves and everything going on within this small town of Europe. But also, let's not forget, the title of Resident Evil 8 has been leaked in having to suggest that Resident Evil 8 will be titled Resident Evil 8 Village, and within this village, very similar to Resident Evil 4, we're going to be experiencing something that is outside the norm, very similar to Resident Evil 4 by concept design, but also taking everything we've experienced from Resident Evil 4 and boosting that with steroids and giving us what we're going to be getting for this upcoming Resident Evil title. Now again, having Capcom allow this game to be explorative in a sense to where you get to visit different environments and really be immersed within your surrounding, what you don't want to make this game feel like is one of those basic open world games similar to The Last of Us 2. You want to have this game kind of be centered and grounded similar to Silent Hill, to where you could still explore and go to specific locations and having to visit specific environments and take a look at your overall setting, but at the same time, you don't want the game to feel repetitive, you don't want the game to feel as if there's no replay value, and more importantly, you don't want to make this game feel similar to how the story was within the Resident Evil 3 remake, to where it was short and they took so much out. Now, Resident Evil 8, by comparison, it is being said to be, quote, 10 times longer than Resident Evil 7. And Resident Evil 7 actually did what every horror fan wanted from Capcom, and that's giving us a solid, good, and objectively scary Resident Evil game, unlike Resident Evil 6, which was a complete dumpster fire. But even now, when looking at what Resident Evil 8 could be, with the game having to basically portray images of canines and having all of these ritualistic things happening, what our characters in the game could end up stumbling across are very similar concepts to what we've seen be done in Resident Evil 4, with Sadler having to control a small village of people. But here, we're taking that to a whole nother extreme in having awakenings and ritualistic sacrificial practices happening. So the game itself is looking as if it's going to take a lot of the modern versions of some of the best horror movies that have been out within the last couple of years and merging that all into one. And the best part about this is we are going to be having the return of zombies, but the question here are, what kind of zombies are we going to see? Are we going to see the slow-moving zombies that we are so accustomed to within Resident Evil 1, Resident Evil 2, and 3, or are we going to have a more evolved version of what these zombies could be, in a sense to where they're able to run very similar to Crimson Heads, or perhaps maybe they're able to continuously go after you even after dismembering them, having to rip their limbs apart? They just keep coming at you because there's something more other than a standard virus keeping them from falling apart. There's something more, there's something ritualistic about not only these people having to be infected with a new virus, but perhaps maybe there is something more keeping them afloat in wanting to take you down. But what I also believe needs to happen in this game to really set the precedent here is a major character needs to be killed off. Now, the reason why I say this is because you need to introduce a different element, an element of desperation, an element of hopelessness, an element to where you're in an environment now to where thus far we've seen many of our beloved characters, Jill, Claire, Leon, Chris, Jake, Barry, everyone basically survived. There's always a sense to where a character ends up walking away with their life, but here in Resident Evil 8, how crazy would it be if for the first time we get to see how a well-known character within the series itself is actually killed by the cult while exploring this, in a sense to where now you understand the gravity of the situation. This isn't your standard biological attack. This isn't your standard cult being behind wanting to take control. No, instead, we have a situation be presented to where you do feel hopeless, and it kind of gives us the Outlast / Outlast 2 vibes, in a sense to where you're in this particular environment, and for you to stay alive, you're going to have to go through desperate measures in order to keep your life intact and walk away by the end unscathed and with all of the answers to the questions that you had going into the game itself. But more importantly than anything else, not make the game kind of feel similar to Call of Duty or any other shooter. You want to have this experience be very similar to Outlast as an example, or any other game that captures the horror elements, versus having to just go right in there with a weapon or with a gun and just simply blow your way through and then end the game off on a whim. But in the end, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below on how you guys personally feel about Resident Evil 8. Do you guys believe that Resident Evil 8 should be an open world game to where it allows you to explore essentially everywhere you go and kind of dive deeper into your environment? Or do you think that specific locations ought to be cut off and have the game basically be linear? And in terms of the cults, the werewolves, the witches, the zombies, and many of the monsters that are going to be included in this game, what are your overall thoughts as to what is to be expected? Are you guys in for having somewhat of a cult be the main enemies of this game, very similar to what we've seen go down in Resident Evil 4? Or do you guys believe that there needs to be a twist, perhaps maybe again Umbrella be behind the shadows working in secret, or a different company? Should there be a head honcho per se? And what about Ether Winters' story along with Chris Redfield having to be included in the game? Again, Chris is getting another redesign, so are we going to see the muscular Chris come back? Are we going to see a older, much skinnier Chris come back? It's really up in the air right now, but in the end, I want to get your thoughts about this game in the comment section below. Once more, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for listening. If, of course, you guys are stoked, ready, and excited for Resident Evil 8, then I do encourage you guys to smash that subscribe button down below and slap this video up with a big thumbs up, especially if you guys are waiting for Capcom to give us a first look of what this game is going to look like. I want to get your thoughts down below. Thank you all so much for watching. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace.